pie-in-the-sky political promises don't pass muster at Hall's Bakery. Churning out Chorley cakes and other stomach-filling fare since 1933, it went into administration 3 years ago before being rescued by the founder's grandson. Joe Hall, a former soldier, doesn't blame the government for that, but he does say that after 13 years in power, it's grown complacent.
When I voted Labour for Tony Blair in 1997, I really believe the country needed a change. Conservatives have been in for a long time, and it definitely needed to happen. I think my own opinion is that right now, the country needs a change. And I'm leaning towards the Conservatives as the party that can provide that change.
His customers show a similar distaste for the current state of affairs.
Never voted Labour, and I certainly wouldn't vote for Labour on the past history that they've got at the moment.
Just recently they've disgraced themselves and I wouldn't want to vote for any of them.
The general election will be won or lost in constituencies like Chorley. The Conservatives need an 8% swing from Labour if they're to steal this seat from the ruling party's clutches, something that, if replicated nationwide, would mean an overall Conservative victory. But this former cotton milling community is interesting for another reason. Since 1964, whichever party has won here has won the general election. Chorley, in other words, is a swing seat, akin to, say, Florida or Colorado in US elections. This time round, it matters even more than usual.
This election is likely to be very close, closer than we've seen for some time. And that means that every vote will count in marginal constituencies and every seat will count when it comes to election day.
Along the waterways that fed Chorley's once booming cotton mills, we find a glimmer of hope for Gordon Brown.
I always vote Labour, I always have done sort of thing, you know. It's not done so bad.
Fishing for votes here will not be a foregone conclusion. The people of Chorley, and marginals like it, know that come May the 6th, their votes will most definitely count. Elliot Gotkin, Bloomberg News, Chorley, Northwest England.